like, she's at home, I'm at home, I can work for 4 or 5 hours, you know, baby's gonna sleep, baby's gonna cry, I'll be up. I actually think it'll be an advantage because now I'll be up for all of the late sport night events.
Oh, that's true.
You can watch it.
Yeah.
Report on actually seeing.
Speaking of which, the United States basketball team is now the gold medal.
Started at midnight last night.
After all our angst, they defeated Australia 97-78. Outscoring them in the third quarter, 32-10. They were down by 15 points midway through the second quarter.
At the stop sign, turn right onto Gooley Lake Road. Then turn left onto Union Lake Road.
I checked it out because it's June the 13th.
What turned you off?
It's my luck. Yeah. I'm not very good. My friends are telling me I'm a bush. I'm
just tired of giving money away?
Yeah, so I said, Australia plus 12.5. Let's look
at the light. Turn left onto Union Lake Road. And then turn right onto Gooley Lake Road.
I swear to God, I said first half looks better. But, so I bet on the game, of course.
Thank you.
United States.
Every American thanks you.
I know. Exactly. Durant with 23. Devin Booker with 20. So they'll play the gold medal against the winner of Slovenia and France. Now, they've lost to France already. Slovenia has Luka, among other players. So that comes up at 7 o'clock. We're going to go off the air and broadcast that. And the U.S. women's soccer team did win the bronze.
Yes. So they medaled. Congratulations.
Exactly. It's a beautiful thing. Also, in the world of Monty Bates, reclassified. He is now eligible to start college basketball.
At the line, turn right onto Cooley Lake Road.
Allegedly, it's down to Michigan State, who he committed to originally and then decommitted. Oregon, hashtag Nike.
#2.6 miles, turn right onto Hiller Road.
Side of things, at least old school mentality is if you're going to decommit, then you can go somewhere else.
858-6688 for more information. On the show,
in 2.2 miles, turn left onto Commerce Road.
We asked people in Michigan why they got the COVID-19 vaccine.
Because I am 24 weeks pregnant and we wanted to protect our baby boy.
The vaccine to protect my family, protect my friends, and help our community.
Believe in the science.
Why did you get vaccinated?
My best friend couldn't. She caught COVID and passed away the day before her birthday. That is my why.
I want to hug my mom again. I haven't been able to hug her in over a year.
I want to hug my grandma again.
And I'm ready to get back to somewhat normal.
All the vaccines have been tested for safety and are trusted by doctors.
I'm vaccinated. I'm coming to give you a big hug. I love you, Mom.
You've got your why. Now find the vaccine near you at michigan.gov/COVID-vaccine. A message from the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services.
According to research, 82% of people remember radio ads. That means that 82% of you listening right now will remember that this is an ad for ZipRecruiter. If you're hiring, 82% of you will recall that ZipRecruiter makes hiring faster and easier. And 82% of you will note that you can try ZipRecruiter for free today. But you have to go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. Yes, free. 82% of you will keep in mind that ZipRecruiter's technology finds qualified people for your job and actively invites them to apply.
No, is that you? Who are you talking to?
82% of you will also know that I am live with my mom. But the most important thing to note is that ZipRecruiter works.
Turn left onto Commerce Road.
Qualified employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Will you be part of the 82% who remember where you can try ZipRecruiter for free? It's ZipRecruiter.com/free. Again, that exclusive link is ZipRecruiter.com/free. How much? Free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Please donate to Kroger's 3rd Annual Zero Hunger Emergency Food Drive. Over 50 police officers will be on site August 7th from 11 till 3, collecting non-perishable food items. For participating Kroger stores, visit 971theticket.com/feedmish.
FanDuel Sportsbook is hooking new users up with an epic Olympic bonus. Just place your first bet on any Olympic sport risk-free. That's correct. New users get up to $1,000 back in site credit if your first bet doesn't win. To get you started, here's one of my picks. Take the
go
U.S.
Past the site,
to beat Nigeria.
The next one. Turn
okay?
Left.
It's bound to happen one of these years. You can bet on any Olympic event, baseball, soccer, track and field, whatever you want.
At the light.
It's
America's turn left onto
number
Commerce
one
Road.
Sportsbook. Download the FanDuel Sportsbook app with promo code WOJO and go for the gold today. That's promo code WOJO. You must be 21 or older and present in Michigan. First online real money wager only for risk-free bet. Refund issued is non-withdrawable site credit that expires in 7 days. Restrictions
in 2.7 apply. Miles.
See sportsbook.fanduel.com for details.
Road.
Gambling problems? Call 1-800-270-7117.
According to research, 82% of people remember radio ads. So, 82% of you listening will remember that this is an ad for ZipRecruiter. 82% of you will note that if you're hiring, ZipRecruiter finds qualified people for your job. In fact, 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. And 82% of you will remember that you can try ZipRecruiter for free. But you have to go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. Yes, free. Again, that's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Hi, I'm David Hall from Hall Financial. If you haven't refinanced your mortgage in 2021, you need to call Hall Financial right now to see if you qualify for our no appraisal 8-day close. Call today, 248-308-5000, or go to callhallfirst.com.
Let your voice be heard. Call the D Las Vegas 97.1 The Ticket Studio Line at 248-539-9797. The D Las Vegas, the home for Detroit sports in Vegas.
The Detroit Tigers host the Boston Red Sox. Pre-game today at 12:50 on 97.1 The Ticket. Live from the Jamie Samuelson studio, here's Stoney and Jansen.
97.1 The Ticket. The telephone number is 248-539-9797. Of course, that's also the ticket text number as well. Bryson DeChambeau, we had the pleasure of interviewing. He's a pretty good guy when we interviewed him. is.
He's unique.
That's one way of putting it, yes. He spoke yesterday for the first time since he had to withdraw from the Olympics because of a positive COVID test. You know, it happens. Nobody thought anything of it. Mm-hmm. But yesterday he revealed to ESPN that he wasn't vaccinated. Okay, that's his choice.
Yeah.
And the way players and things are, people are being, you know, taken out of service, it's not helping you do your job. But in this case, well, no, in this case, actually, it's for, you know, it's still individual, even though you're representing your country. So, but anyway, that said, his rationale just made no sense to me. He said the vaccine doesn't necessarily prevent it from happening, which is true. I'm young enough, I'd rather give the vaccine to people who need it. I don't need it. I'm a healthy young individual that will continue to work on my health. And he told a story about his parents having it. He just did not want to be one of those people that, because he got a vaccine and he's healthy, somebody else wouldn't be able to get the vaccine.
We're not at that place right anymore.
What planet is this guy living on? So this is not, look, I don't want all the vaxxers, or the anti-vaxxers say, you know, you pick it up. No, I just, if you didn't want to do it, whatever, okay? But to use that as your excuse just shows you're a moron.
Well, I don't necessarily know it shows he's a moron, but I also think it just gets back to the question by itself. Like, are you vaxxed? And we ran into this with Taylor Decker with the Lions. And he said,
at the next light,
and I don't
turn
want to
left.
Give my reasons why I didn't.
Which is fine.
Right, but there's so many people that say, I need to know the reason.
Well, I don't know if he was asked.
You have one guy that doesn't give his reason, and he takes crap for it. And then you have another guy that gives his reason, and because we don't think it's a good reason, we give him crap for it.
Well, this reason, he should get crap for this.
Well, I'm not going to agree with the reason, because I think there is, and it's been proven, there's enough vaccine for anybody who wants one.
Right, that's it. That's my whole thing. If he doesn't want to get it,
I mean, I do agree with his reason for not getting it in regards to I'm young, I'm healthy, and I'm going to continue to work on my health. If that's the decision that he wants to make, that is where he should have stopped. All right, because he is young, healthy. He's always talked about and shown on many Instagram, social media posts that he works on his health. That's fine, but that's where it should have stopped.
Exactly.
Not, you know, I want to make sure that those that I don't want to take one away from somebody that really needs it.
No, people are,
we're not in that place
we're
anymore.
We're begging people to get vaccines. They're ending up throwing vaccines away.
Right.
Because there are not enough people who take it. So just don't show your ignorance. That's my whole point with DeChambeau.
Yeah.
Nothing else. Like I said, if you're not going to get the vaccine, it's your choice.
Well, I think it was, and I don't remember, Heather, if we talked about this in the news, but there is an uptick, I know, at least in the state of Michigan, of people getting vaccinated.
We didn't talk about it, but I will talk about it today.
Spoiler alert.
Thank you.
Coming up at 6:35, Heather's news. Now, you were talking about off air what's going on with the National Football League and the Players Association.
Yeah, the National Football League and the NFLPA there's been this give and take relationship since, you know, COVID came.
Right.
And they were able to get in all, you know, 17 weeks last year, 16 games, playoffs. There was some hoops that they had to jump through.
Tuesday night football.
Some gymnastics that we saw on the football side of things.
2.2 miles. They got it all in. Turn right onto Olds Telegraph Road.
They, you know, with the availability of the vaccine, they said, hey, there's going to be a set of rules for those that are vaccinated and one for those that are unvaccinated. And one of the major reasons that a lot of guys got vaccinated was because they weren't going to have to go through the daily testing.
Right.
And now the NFLPA yesterday came out and said they're pushing for daily testing for all players, vaccinated and unvaccinated. And
how does their union, where's the rank and file stand on this?
I think the rank and file is going to be upset because they've done this so that, and here's where you run into an issue when you have a bye week and you want to, you know, you're fully vaccinated. As Americans, if we're fully vaccinated, we can go on planes. We wear masks on planes, but you can go and you can go see you know, maybe you have family that your family, your wife and kids are living in a different city.
Right.
On a bye week, you can go see them. Well, if you have daily testing throughout the season, you can't, because if you miss a daily test, they're reporting that the fine is going to be $50,000. That is ridiculous. And if you are fully vaccinated, you've done what they asked you to do. You knew what the rules were going to be for vaccinated and unvaccinated. You followed the playbook, and now at the last minute, they're going to change the rules.
I'm stunned that this is not coming from the league. If you told me this story, all right, yep. Who's setting this up?
I trust Goodell, me. I read it a bunch of times to Goodell, make sure I didn't get it wrong.
Goodell or the Players Association, you'd say the league, right?
Yes.
I am just stunned that the union
in 1 mile,
wants this.
Turn right onto Odessa Telegraph Road.
You're stunned because this is the union that left a loophole for 17 or 18 games, and then when the NFL owners took advantage of that rule, they are like, wait, what a second. We don't want to play 17 games. Well, your union said it was going to be okay. I mean, there's a bunch of things, and DeMaurice Smith is the head of the NFLPA.
Right.
All of these things.
But he's got players. I mean, there are players on his board, right?
Yes, there are players on the board. And there's a trainer down in Cleveland. Their center is the head rep. I don't understand why the NFLPA would be pushing for this, other than the fact that it's just good optics. Like, there's got to be some PR reason for the NFLPA. And I don't know what that is.
The only thing I can think of, now, I would say, give me a number or a percentage you think of the players that have been vaccinated, 80, 85% around the league, something like that?
I think it's
in that range,
it's
right?
Above 85%.
Okay.
Yeah, some things are better than others.
Maybe they're doing this to protect
go past
the
light,
other rank
then at the
file
next one,
members
turn
who
right.
have not been vaccinated. I don't
That's
know.
That's their choice, but it's their
no,
choice.
I know, but I'm just on the union. I'm forgetting about that. I don't understand.
It's absurd.
It makes no sense. I'm trying to figure out the rationale of why the union would want
at the light, turn right onto Odessa Telegraph Road.
Trust me.
Then turn left onto Golf
all
Drive.
I'm trying to figure it out. I don't get it. I don't know why it would be coming from the NFLPA.
This whole vaccination thing with the league.
Turn left onto Golf Drive. Then turn right.
Not everybody. 80% seems to be all lockstep. Beautiful. We're going to have a season.
Yes.
And, you know, those who aren't, they know they have to go through, you know, their daily testing. They're up on the board. And, you know, you're seeing more and more teams like
turn
Washington.
Right. Then turn right onto Wagner Road.
Had a major spike in vaccinations over the last week. And that's, that to me is the other thing. When your coach is Ron Rivera and he's compromised because he's cancer, you don't get to.
Yeah, that we talked about that. I think we talked about it earlier in the week.
Yeah.
I don't understand that. And like, you can make your decision
turn
whatever
right.
you want to make. But you and I have talked about this.
Yeah.
Like, you got
turn left,
vaccine
then arrive.
For certain reasons.
Right.
I got mine for, you know, some similar but some different.
Right.
And I think it's better for us to be in the same studio.
Yeah.
To make that possible, I had to get the vaccine.
Right.
Heather had to get the vaccine. You had to get the vaccine.